Congressman John Yarmuth says his office has been inundated with hundreds of calls. It moved him so much he could not hold back tears at a public Christmas party as he apologized for what he called his inaction on Capitol Hill concerning gun violence. Ann Bowden joins us now with more on the congressman's unexpected apology. Ann?
Well, Vicki, it is not often that you hear a congressman publicly admit he was wrong, folded under pressure, and made a big mistake. But during a holiday celebration at Wayside Christian Mission, John Yarmuth choked back tears as he asked for the state's forgiveness for being silent on gun control. Singing a song that asks for heavenly protection, dozens gathered at Congressman John Yarmuth's annual Cards for the Homeless. Then he asked for forgiveness for the lack of his protection.
I've been largely silent on the issue of gun violence over the past 6 years. And I am now as sorry for that as I am for what happened to the families who lost so much in this most recent, but sadly not isolated, tragedy.
In a candid, often emotional speech, the congressman admitted he fell silent on gun control and violence because he felt outnumbered on Capitol Hill.
But I think it was probably just, you know, the feeling of helplessness that I would be a voice crying in the wilderness and it wasn't worth talking about. And that's, again, that was my mistake. It's not going to happen anymore.
Yarmuth pointed the finger at the heavy hand he feels the National Rifle Association has on Congress.
I believe it is more rational to fear guns than it is to fear the illusory political power of the NRA.
For Yarmuth, the violence in Connecticut brought back memories of other shootings, particularly of his colleague, Congresswoman Gabrielle Gifford, and the 9-year-old girl killed in that incident.
I think this will it already has. It's created a mass public outcry for action.
Action, he says, begins with him.
I intend to be part of that action, and I promise my constituents, the families of the bereaved in Connecticut, my own family, and every American family, I will not be silent any longer.
Now, Yarmuth says that he believes stopping the sale of ammunition online and monitoring large or excessive purchases of ammunition is a start. And for the weapons themselves, he hopes to bolster conversation on Capitol Hill to reinstate the federal assault weapons ban that existed from 1994 to 2004. Now, that ban meant including civilian use, excluding civilian use for semi-automatic weapons. Ann Bowden, WLKY News.